baseball is back. I'm Andrew Tenelian with My Arlington TV, and even though we can't go in person right now, unless it is that you were awesome and you bought one of these, the Rangers still got you. They've posted some of the recipes of their favorite concessions online. So yes, this is going exactly where you think it's going. If I can make all of this, you too can make this at home. We're doing four recipes. The Hot Flamin' Cheetos Dog, which is probably in terms of difficulty gonna be the easiest. Then come the Bacon Wrapped Wings, then the Dilly Dog, this is gonna be technical. And the final one, the big boss, the Wicked Pig. First up, the Flamin' Hot Cheetos Dog. This one is by far the easiest. Grab some hot dogs, cook them however you want. Grab some cheese sauce, warm that however you want. And while all of that is going on in the background, open a small bag of Hot Flamin' Cheetos and put a third of that bag into another resealable bag, because you're going to pound them into a powder that once you get it fine enough, you'll mix in with the nacho cheese sauce. Now it's time for assembly. And of course you know the order. The bun, the dog, the cheese sauce, and then the leftover Cheetos for garnish on top. And out of all of the recipes, this comes pretty close to what you'll see at the ballpark. Now for the Dilly Dog. And as I was about to do it, I actually started cooking the chicken for the bacon-wrapped wings. Because while those are cooking in the oven, I started heating a pot of oil to fry them as well as the Dilly Dog. Now it's time to core a jumbo pickle. Obviously, an apple corer is going to go a long way here. But I didn't have that. All I had was a modified jumbo funnel and a serrated knife. But once you get it started, it's actually a lot easier than it seems. The inside is squishy and honestly like gutting a pumpkin. Next, you'll want to mix your dry ingredients in one bowl, and that's going to be all-purpose flour, sugar, salt, and baking soda. Then, in a separate bowl, comes your wet ingredients, which is milk and a large egg. Once you have the two, obviously you mix them into one. Once you have it all incorporated, and it's gonna take a little while, take your pickle with the hot dog already inside and roll it lightly onto cornstarch, which of course, this is not the best example of. This is far too thick. And knowing what I know now, I would have a thinner layer. From there, you'll dip it into the dough, making sure it's fully covered. Then it's time to fry it, either in your fryer or, like you're seeing here, the pot of hot oil. This oil is at 325 degrees, and you're gonna wanna let this fry for roughly 6 minutes. When it was done, I was pretty happy with the look of it. The only real improvement would have actually been to use a jumbo hot dog instead of a regular one. There's a lot of empty space inside the pickle that I wasn't prepared for. You can easily get a jumbo hot dog or even a sausage inside. Now the bacon-wrapped chicken wings. The chicken is done and the chicken has cooled, which means it's time to wrap it in bacon and then fry it. This is where things go horribly wrong. And this video becomes far more for your entertainment than your education. Number one, I should have used toothpicks to keep the bacon on. Number two, I should have checked the temperature of my oil. Between the time it took me to pull the Dilly Dog out and then wrap all of the chicken in bacon, the oil, unbeknownst to me, jumped from 325 to more than 460 degrees, which of course you've already figured out when I put this chicken in, instantly burned the bacon. I did try it again with the temperature much lower to where it should be, and for these, the recipe calls for 350 degrees, but as you can see, it doesn't quite look right. And this isn't the one that I thought I'd strike out on, but I would have much better luck with the Wicked Pig. I put a large pork butt in the crock pot, cooking low and slow, 8 hours before I began this entire production. Then cooked the sausage. So now all that's left is assembly. Bottom bun first, then a slice of ham, then pulled pork with a barbecue sauce mixed in, then the sausage cut lengthwise, prosciutto if you can find it, and I couldn't when I was buying everything. than 2 pieces of bacon, which I forgot I needed because I binged the rest of it eating my feelings over the frying fiasco with the wings. For some crunch, add coleslaw. Do it all one more time. The ham, the pulled pork, the sausage, prosciutto, bacon and coleslaw, and then of course, the top bun. This one I was happy with too, and you can also add pork rinds as a side like they do at the ballpark. All things considered, this was a lot of fun, though certainly not of the professional quality that you'll get at Globe Life Field, right in the heart of Arlington, the American Dream City. We'll see you soon.